Hi children, the last class we saw about melting, freezing and condensation. Now we are going to see the other examples. Now let us see boiling. Now let us see the definition for boiling. The process during which liquid changes into gas at fixed temperature on heating is called as boiling. You all have seen boiling in your home, am I right children? Listen, let me show as an activity here. I have taken a little amount of water. Right here, when I heat this at 100 degrees Celsius, this water will start to boil. How can you see that it's boiling? Look at this glass of water. This is a boiled water. You can see the bubbles, am I right? When it is on the stove, you can see the bubbles. Am I right? Now it is a boiled water. So you can witness the gas particles there. Am I right, children? So the liquid water on boiling, right, at a fixed temperature, it changes into gas. This is an example for boiling. Right, yeah? Let me say the definition once again. The process during which liquid changes into gas at fixed temperature on heating is called as boiling. Now let us see evaporation, children. Now let us see the definition for this evaporation. The process during which liquid changes into vapor at the temperature, note down here, it is at the temperature below the boiling point. It's at the temperature below the boiling point is called evaporation. Are you able to understand, children? Right. What we can say as an example for this evaporation, right, children? Look at here. I'm going to take this hot water. Look at here. Now it is below its boiling point. Am I right? You can see a little amount of fumes coming out. Am I right? It means that it is getting converted into vapor now. Am I right? Yeah. So this water, liquid water, changes into vapor below its boiling point. So what we can say, evaporation process is occurring at here. Am I right, children? Now let us see the next example, that is dissolving. Dissolving is also a physical change. Am I right, yeah? Look at here. No new substance is going to form at here. I have taken a jaggery powder. Look at here. I have taken a jaggery powder. Right? I am going to add a little amount of water to this jaggery powder. Look at here. I have taken a jaggery powder and I have added a water to it. Now you all know that what's the process occurring at here? The jaggery powder gets dissolved, am I right? Gets dissolved in water. So dissolving, after dissolving, what we can say, can you witness any new substance at here? No, no new substance is formed at here, am I right? When I heat this solution again, I'll get back the jaggery powder, am I right? Yeah. So dissolving is also a physical change. Right, yeah? So we have completed dissolving. Now we are going to move to sublimation. Now let us see the definition for the sublimation, yeah? The process of change of solid directly into gas on heating is called sublimation. Right? We are going to heat a solid substance. This solid substance directly, when it changes into gas, then it is called a sublimation. Right? Now let us do an activity for this. We have to take a sublime substance, right? Sublime substance are nothing but the substance which has the capability to change from solid into gas directly on heating is called as sublime substances. Example for such sublime substances are camphor, iodine, solid carbon dioxide and naphthalene balls. Listen, I have taken camphor here, dear. Listen here, what is the state of this camphor here? Right, what is the state? It is in solid state. Am I right, yeah? Now I am going to heat this camphor. Right, let's look at here. I am just heating this camphor. What will happen if I heat this camphor, children? It will change into gaseous state. When I heat this camphor, it will change into gaseous state, right? The solid substance is directly changing into gas on heating, so it does nothing but sublimation, right? What can I do this when I, if I want this camphor again, then what I have to do this, I want to take this gas, I want to cool this gas, right, children? When I cool this gas, it will change into solid again. This process is called as deposition. Are able to understand, children? Right? In both these processes, we are not getting any new substances. Am I right? Both the processes are reversible in nature. So, what we can say? Yeah, physical change has occurred. Right, children? What we can say? Yeah, physical change has occurred. Thank you, children. I hope you have understood the concept. Thank you, children.